off. The eyes are on Arestia. Can he get a great start? Which doesn't look like he has. But Dougie Falcons right up into P2. Going for the lead into turn one. Goes a little deep, but is there in P2. Making up that
actually is a run from the Ferrari of Acti on Nara. And it is. Nara is losing another place, I think. He's definitely in trouble, isn't he, from those medium tyres. As Cyclex is looking to get past him too.
Starting P2, now down to P7, losing five positions on just one lap. Maybe a cause for concern for how Nara
is up the hill into turn one, and yeah, you've got it done. No DRS activation yet for that advantage that you're going to have come back towards the end. Squeezing out the Ferrari. Ferrari's still committing this to the inside line, but is he going to get the power down? He gets the second corner. Yes, he has. Maintain ahead of it. This is fantastic racing. This is why we like to see it from Carlos. Yeah. Also, potentially even getting corner cutting one's legs. Cyclic's gone a bit twirly-whirly. Definitely going twirly-whirly. He's gone.
Well, I would say that Carlos is a great cameraman, but Cyclic could not withstand the heat.
So during that, he's ahead of both the Ferraris, actually. EDU's joined this party. So that's a Ferrari-powered party right there between Carlos Acti and EDU. And I think Carlos patiently sat back there and said, okay, well, you guys battle, snuck on through to the other side.
Possibly crashed again, or that Jacob. Is actually Jacob. The Red Bull driver of Jacob has spun. So unfortunately, he has gone down the grid quite a bit.
Like the sun might start peeking out of those clouds more. So no chance of rain just yet, and there is Acti taking the very early undercut.
He might be feeling some struggle.
A bit of an undercut. I think lap 10, but currently 57% I'm showing for his front left tire. So that is a little earlier than anticipated. But then again, hard tires again. Whoa, interesting. Another one on the hard tires. Mediums Cyclics. For Cyclics.
Yeah, see, mediums for Cyclics. So that's fitting the normal picture that we've been hearing, as well as assuming to come out of these drivers.
It's back onto the racing line. Oh, and look at that. Jacob didn't get a catch caught off there because Carlos is massively struggling with traction right now in the Alfa Romeo.
Look at Narasthaya. Janos that are on 3.6 or, you know, fresh tires, they're not going to pit, but these 8-lap runners will definitely, it will be in the talks with their engineer. Hey, are we pitting? Are we pitting? Any longer. And he actually caught out Tigzy quite a bit. 7.5 tenths, but those 11-lap-old mediums are going to show their wear very quickly. He's been doing a great job. That Haas has been very large, keeping Dougie behind, but this is the closest these two have battled, and Dougie's going to make a move up on the inside. Does push Tigzy a little wide, and Dougie loses the back end. He's now in, side by side. You know, Tigzy needs to give the room now. Come to the penultimate corner into the run of the final turn. Dougie is ahead, but how long will that last? It's because Tigzy is battling
DeFalcon's way, and Falcon's like, not on my watch, my friend. I am the sharpest Falcon in the shed, and he's back up in the lead of the race.
Yeah, and side by side through the first sector.
That battle from Dougie, Tigzy, EDU, and it's Leonard and Rob Nara right now. It's got Carlos keeping him behind. They're doing a really good job, I have to say, on the restart, aren't they, on these hard tyres, keeping up the soft runners quite well. Mediums, I mean. You can't just ghost your way through a car. Yeah, I'm still quite surprised, because if it is AI controlled, the AI would slap that car in the pit lane immediately.
Yeah, as Tigzy is DRS, so, you know, gonna start reeling him in.
That fish. But this party just behind them wants to join that battle. So far, so good, getting over halfway through the race, and this is where we're gonna see more of that racing into overtaking entertainment, aren't we there, One Shark?
Oh, Narasthaya was thinking about it. Ooh, Carlos actually was thinking about it too. But this is where we're going to see, really, that DRS performance as Narasthaya loses the back end, just showing you the gap from 1.2 to Tigzy. So Dougie is really trying to take the pace out of his tires now and create that gap for later.
We'll be there.
Yeah, and on board with Narasthaya, really trying to close in on its Leonard. Tries to make a move, but thinks otherwise. Narasthaya. But still having issues closing in to Narasthaya as Jacob looks to have been back, and it's Leonard is now battling on board with Narasthaya, I think, is the camera. And, well, but Jacob also going for the pit now. 16 laps, might have some wing damage too. It is time to get that job.
Well, lap 18 and 28.
But looking at the top, Tigzy just hovering barely around that DRS detection area. So hopefully he can try to get that well within 1 second, like now.
No, he hasn't come out of pit stop. So look at this battle. Oh, let's let it out after a spin. Sorry, that's my apologies. That's the reason why. Look at this. Two for Nail. Elbows out. Glenn and it's Leonard battling it out. He's run board with Nick's TK.
And it looks like Glenn also got behind Nick. Possibly giving him the position, but in our Wing Racing, the prime opportunity, DRS, as close as he's been for laps and laps, side by side, and pulls ahead just cleanly.
3% front left, mate, with 8 laps to go. That doesn't look too good, does it?
It does not. And Tigzy might just be on the better setup to manage those tires. But this is where Dougie, you see him just reel in Tigzy. Will he try to make the move into turn 12? He does. He's going for it. It's very tight between these two, but that is the quality and class of driving that these two drivers and respect that they also give each other as well.
We don't see these cars battling it out there. You can see the other drivers is hanging in there. Now he's down 1.6 seconds down the road. He may very well look at breaking that DRS soon. He has to. Going to be running out of time with 7 laps to go.
Tigzy really wants to hope he can keep defending Dougie, but
Jacob got passion, but he's back in control of that car. He's got Glenn for company, and Nick's completely out of the way there, saying, I'm just
there it is, Nars Diet, pretty easily and comfortably in that deal. Yeah, I definitely would say, as Dougie's going for the move onto Tigzy, he was able to get ahead, but will Tigzy fight him back and see where he is? Looks like Dougie was able to make the pass, which is what exactly he's wanting.
At the right
as
moment.
Tigzy is going for a move. Turn 12 onto Dougie. They are side by side. Tigzy does push Dougie off, but then Dougie goes right back at Tigzy. And Nars Diet is now in the mix. Wheel the wheel with Dougie Falcons.
Yeah, they'll send it through there. It's coming up now. You can see the low, how low that pass is driving, isn't it? A little bit of a lift there from Nara. You want to hit slap Tigzy up the back?
Tigzy runs over one of the sausage turbs into turn 12, but that does not stop the Dougie, the Falcon. He will not relent any longer, but will need to push just that much more.
That's mediums and hards once again. So that battle between the tires is really coming into play now as we're getting to the very, very business end of this championship.
Yeah, and look at that red flashing light on both Tigzy and on Dougie. Both really just putting everything on the line now.
Anytime soon. We'll keep an eye on that one. There he is there. And I think that's going to be almost easy peasy taking candy from Bay, because Jacob, the has got passion, has the best tire.
There you go. There's the red light of Tigzy. The outside as Tigzy goes for the inside. Does Dougie take the switch back? No, he doesn't. But he's closer than he has been in the last 3 laps. This is tight racing. Do everything he can to close in to Tigzy, as he definitely thought he was going to try to make a move as Tigzy locks up. But Nars Diet makes the move, and these two are definitely coming down from the grid. Dougie is possibly complaining about other floor damage that we can't see. Though the outside of the body does look good, there might be some issues underneath that is causing him to have.
Who's going
to
get that P3? It could very much, it will be Carlos, I'd have to say.
And Nars Diet making the move on Tigzy. On track, though, so Tigzy will still be taking P1 unless Tigzy picks up a 3-second penalty. He's going to know will definitely be taking P2, it looks like. But Tigzy taking it home, P1. What a fantastic drive.
Enjoy that.
Where's the cowboy hats?
Yes, yeah, so where are the cowboy hats, my friend, for the Finnish driver? A Finn, 1-2. And obviously adding Mr. Dougie Falcons there, doing it for Frank Williams, no doubt, to get that third place.